So welcome everybody. Very good morning to everybody, and thank you for coming here on a Sunday morning. I hope you all are curious about Bose.x, and you'll get to know everything about Bose.x that is required for you to know. And yeah, let's start with our journey to getting know what is Bose.x and why are we organizing this orientation for you guys. So yeah. So first of all, who are we? Like, as of now, you must have attended a lot of orientations from several clubs of SVNIT, several different student organizations related to maybe something like CHRD or something else. So similarly, our organization was a very focused. Our organization was established with a very focused aim. It was founded by Ankul Prajapati, our very own alumni who graduated in 2020 from Mechanical Engineering branch of SVNIT Surat. And Bose.x is an independent, multidisciplinary research organization. And more specifically speaking, it is an undergraduate research organization. So, what actually Bose.x is? It is a platform for student researchers. Where we provide a conducive environment for everybody to pursue their research interest, or if somebody wants to explore what is research or how research is done, or to just get a flavor of how a career in research could be. So Bose.x is a platform where you should look for. And it was established for like providing guidance for students. Like in India, it is not like US, right? In US, there are lots of opportunities in all the universities to pursue research in some or the other way. But in India, there is a very shunted view towards research. Like research is not something looked upon as a very first option of a career, right? Everybody knows that. So Bose.x is for those people who are curious enough to go into the depths of a topic or something they are very curious about. Like I'm not just talking about the popular science, that is the black hole, quantum computing, and etc. But every domain of physics, chemistry, biology, medicine, engineering, etc., where there is a need for curious people. And yeah, Bose.x is the platform where the students like us who are undergraduates, who are not actually PhD students, but who are taking courses as you are taking, but exploring something out of the books that is not taught in the classroom. So I'll shortly explain what our logo represents. So as you can see, Bose.x. So the B here is those of you who have studied electronics or will be studying electronics. The B symbol is the triac symbol. It is an electronic component. The O is the very famous image of the black hole. The S is the like it's not exactly, but it's the spin dynamics of an electron spin over a Bloch sphere, and E is the symbol of an euro. So I'll explain what that means actually. So we are like our motto is TRIARC, like training for research, innovation, and commercialization. So training for research, obviously I explained you like in Indian universities, research is not something very active or undergraduate students don't usually do that, right? So research is our main motive, like training people or undergraduate students for getting started with research topics on their own, taking up responsibilities of initiating problems, managing projects, etc. Innovation is something like doing something that is not already done. Like for example, I'll tell you when we complete our final years, we all have to present a thesis project or something like that, or we have to do some specified amount of time in internships, right? So there mostly what people in India do is they reproduce a lot of work that is already done by the research group which they are working in, or which is already being done by the professor. So that is reproductive work, that is not innovation. Like so here what we try is we find problems which are much more innovative that are not explored yet. Yeah, it may not be the biggest part of the problem. Like we don't say that we'll find something new about a quantum computer or we'll find a new particle, something like that. But it could be some portion of it, right? Some mathematical or computational aspect of that problem which has not yet been explored. And that could be a key component to connect a lot of concepts in between. And commercialization is of course the euro symbol here denotes commercialization. Whatever we research or innovate has to be commercialized at some point of time, right? So that is what this logo stands for: training for research, innovation, and commercialization. If you want to know more about it, you can ask any one of us at the end of the session. So moving ahead, I'll explain the structure of Bose.x. Okay, so since before the pandemic happened, the Bose.x was only limited to SVNIT, and we as a group of students used to meet at some location at SVNIT and would discuss upon the proceedings of how to go further with the project, or what should we do to like inculcate more and more research values. But since the pandemic has begun, we have progressed a lot, taking all our workspaces online, and we have efficient workspaces now, and they are divided as follows. The major section of Bose.x is the triad. So all are I guess you guys have heard about Discord, right? Everybody plays gaming channels and music sessions on Discord. So similar to Discord, we have one more application, Slack. Our workspaces are based on Slack. So one of the workspace, which is the major one, is the triarc. So in triarc section, it comprises of all the researchers. So by researchers, I mean that now we are not limited to SVNIT. We have people from various different countries also. We have people working from USA, people from UK, Bangladesh, and etc. Like, there are many more countries where people are applying for taking membership into Bose.x. So researchers who are willing to do the projects, graduate students, obviously some of them are PhD students who are pursuing their PhDs or masters at very well-known universities in the US, France, UK, and the rest of the Europe. There are postdocs, some of the postdocs who have completed their PhDs and looking for research experiences. We have professors in our Slack channel, the triarc, where they help us out with some of the resources or some of the outreach activities which are not just possible by the students. Okay, we need professors at some point of time because they have more outreach than us, more contacts, and obviously more experience than us. And there are lead co-leads. So, okay, I'll get to this point of lead and co-leads further in the session, because right now I'm not talking about the specific sections of Bose.x. I'm only talking about the workspaces and the core members. So the core members comprises of a small amount of people who actually manage the functioning of whole Bose.x, right from the top to the bottom. From the triad to all the collaboration is handled by the core members, and all the functionalities are being discussed over this Slack channel. Similarly, we have a training section. In training section, students who don't have enough experience to start off with the project, we don't reject them usually, because see, if you apply for an internship and if you don't have the prerequisite knowledge or the required amount of skills, they will straight away reject you, or they will tell you to apply after some amount of time, or maybe apply in the next summer. But in Bose.x, we don't usually reject people. We give them another option to settle themselves in the training section. So what happens in the training section is we give them some material related to specific topic of their interest, and they study over that material over a period of time. We train them through getting started with research ideas and stuff, and once they are prepared to start off a project, we take them into the triad channel and kick off the project. There is one more channel, management. The management activities of Bose.x regarding like everything from website handling to social media and the management of the projects, etc., is done on the management channel, which consists of the collaboration coordinators. So Bose.x is not just an individual organization. We have collaborations with other organizations like Spaceonova, which is space oriented and astro oriented organization, Stellar Universe, which is also astronomy and astrophysics oriented organization, and Q India, which is a part of Q World, actually, which is an European organization. And Q India is a sister branch of Q World, working in the quantum domain. So that collaboration coordinators and the sub branch coordinators. So like I said, Bose.x is not only limited to SVNIT now. So we have the option of creating sub branches. Like, anybody wants to run Bose.x on their own at their institute, so they can start off with a sub branch of Bose.x. And we have currently one sub branch at MNIT Allahabad, NIT Allahabad basically. So the candidates of that institute and the core members of their sub branch will be having their own workspace on sub branch, and the collaboration, as I said, if we have collaboration with some other organization, we will have a workspace dedicated to them. Okay, so this was a lot more about workspaces, and you don't need to know everything about it. I just wanted to give a flavor of how Bozotex actually runs all these activities remotely. Okay, so those were the workspaces and the management part. So this is actually the core research part, how we divide our sectors, different projects according to the domain which they are in. So we have this five centers. XCQR stands for like X Center for Quantum Research. So all the projects related to quantum physics or quantum computing, quantum information, all that comes under the quantum domain has projects in the quantum research sector. So the project that are currently running in that is now investigation of spin qubits, which are like the workhorse of quantum computing, right? People are doing projects on quantum machine learning. There are projects on cavity quantum electrodynamics and etc. So these are just jargon terms which you will understand eventually if you go through our website, which is www.bozex.org. You go through that, we have individual web pages for these sections. There are description of these projects, so you'll get to know more about these projects, what we actually do by when we say that we do some research project. What we actually do is represented on our website, and if you want to know further, you can email us and like try to contact us. Yeah, similarly with XCAR, so X Center for Astrophysical Research. Here we have various interesting projects, like starting from GW physics. Like I know that everybody has heard about LIGO Virgo detectors and gravitational waves. So there are actually people who are working on GW physics, and they are actually publishing research, right? There are interesting projects on black hole imaging also, and neutron stars, etc. I won't go into the details, as the center lead or co-lead may further explain their projects very well on that topic. Similarly, for engineering science research, we are not only we are not just limited to fundamental research like physics and chemistry, but also engineering sciences. Like engineering, if we have some theories, they are not useful if we don't apply them into our day-to-day lives, right? So we need to find more and more research-based applications that would lead to like sustainable development and like efficient systems in our country as well as the world. So related to the projects related to engineering sections would come under the XCSR section, and the renewable energy and sustainable development projects would come under the XCRST. And yeah, we have a center which is newly established, that is Center for Nuclear Research. So projects related to particle physics or accelerators or the experiments which are done at CERN. So the data analysis of that experiment and producing results is the part of X Center for Nuclear Research. Yeah, feel free to write your answers in the chat box. Yeah, you can put your answers for this also. Okay, so yeah, I have pretty much given a broad idea about what Bose.x is, and yeah, I know that most of you must have got the idea like what actually we do. So yeah, I mentioned it already that we promote undergraduate students to go and explore research as much as they can, right? Because yeah, of course, the people who are doing masters and PhDs are doing because they're interested in research, but what if they didn't know like what they actually wanted to do? Like people spend a lot of time in their masters or their PhDs actually finding what they are actually interested in or what they wanted to do for their whole life, right? We never know like what we want to do. So the best answer to the question that what should we start, what should we pursue or what should we be doing right now is by exploring, right? You should explore as much as you can when you are an undergraduate. Like all of us in Bose.x did the same. Like it's not that we came and into the college and just started with doing research. We explored a lot of streams. We had like SVNIT is a pretty good college and we have a lot of opportunities, so to explore into different domains. Everybody should try different things. And yeah, this is BoseX is also a part of a trying itself, right? We just give it a try to see if our inclinations are towards research or if we are strong at pursuing research or if we are what persevere if we have that perseverance to pursue research and be dedicated to it as an undergraduate. So yeah, Bose.x provides a very good platform to such undergraduates who are very much curious to learn and implement what whatever they have learned into problem-solving skills and like basically to start off with open problems. It is very hard to identify a problem and start working with it. So Bose.x is a platform where you have to come and do that. Our primary goal was to improve the scenario of research in India. As I stated earlier, in India, research is not something which is the first choice of everyone. Majority of students give competitive exams like JEE, KVPY, and etc. etc. A lot of exams are there, but like a very few portion of them are actually interested into research. As a country with a population of 1.3 billion, I think we should have good research programs. Many students should be interested in research, but they don't get opportunities to actually explore research. And yeah, our long-term vision is to create multiple Satyendranath Bose. So that is the inspiration for Bose.x. The name comes from Satyendranath Bose. Like he was a very famous scientist, and yeah, I expect everybody to know about him. Also C.V. Raman, the only Nobel laureate from our country. And we are striving hard to develop this collaboration as with as much as students we can. like the students who are contacting with us, we don't reject usually anybody unless it is an extreme case. We try to take in many of them and train them and like inculcate a quality of developing research attitude or a scientific aptitude towards their daily life also, not only professional but also in their personal lives. So yeah, you all must be thinking that if you want to pursue a research, we can just go under a professor, work with him, do an internship and yeah, like pursue research. Only Bose.exe is not only an option. You can go through summer interns or winter internships and pursue research under a professor, and still you will be able to do research. I'm not saying that you won't be doing research, but there is a reason why Bose.exe was formed and why we are giving this orientation today. So the premier institution like ISER, IITs, NITs are to promote research work, but this is not what happens, right? Everybody goes to IITs and NITs to secure good jobs, good placements and stuff, right? No, nobody comes here for research, or a very small portion of them comes for research. ISERs are specifically dedicated to research, so I won't say that people don't go to ISERs for research. They are research institutes. So Bose.exe is basically for those people and who actually want to do research on their own, start off with independent ideas. If you work with a professor, you won't be independent. You would be doing a portion of his work or his graduate student's work. You won't be doing something of your own. And to like, only to give this like a small caveat that Bose.exe is not for students who don't get internships and stuff. We have students from institutes like ISERS, IISc, even from IITs and from abroad also. So Bose.exe is for everybody. Everybody wants to explore their own problems in a environment where research is the priority, where students are actually interested to develop ideas and work through them. Yeah, and the perception that undergraduate students cannot work independently on their own because they don't have enough knowledge. Yeah, this perception is what Bose.exe is trying to break. Like given the time and effort, every individual can learn whatever he is interested in and try out different stuff. Also, one special thing about Bose.exe is we have people who are from mechanical engineering, but they're interested into gravitational wave physics and astrophysics, and they are very well doing that in Bose.exe. So the flexibility of changing the domains, like if someone is from chemical engineering, he wants to do something in astrophysics, we don't restrict that. If you are ready to develop the required skills for pursuing astrophysics, you are always welcome. And yeah, recently one of our core members, Amitesh Singh, he got an acceptance at University of Mississippi in USA in physics program in the Department of Physics and Astronomy. He was originally from Mechanical Engineering Department of SVNIT. So yeah, you know that we have results also. So okay, so there is a very heuristic approach to the word research, like a very misconception about like researchers. Whenever a movie or something is showing people who are doing research or scientists, they are always shown in a laboratory, scratching their heads, doing mundane routine tasks, roaming here and there with papers. But that is not exactly the picture. Yeah, some domain of research might be, some people might be like that, but it's not a common approach. Like the students like us who have pencil, paper, pen and a laptop can very well do theoretical research. And that is what you will get to know if you try out more and more things in this domain. So yeah, a lot more speaking about the term research. Let us divide it in some subparts, like what actually is research. Research is not something you just go on Google, type some words, read wiki articles and you write a report on it. Okay, that is not a research, because that is the kind of projects you might have been doing till now in schools or in maybe in high schools. So that is not going to work as research. Research is a purely academic activity and you have to give dedicated time and effort to find things that the Google also doesn't know. You have to read research articles, find what problems people are working on, read various PhD or master thesis to get the feel of the topics, read various textbooks which you never heard of in your undergraduate. Yeah, and research is not just about reading and studying or solving problems also. You need to have various skills like computational skills or documentation skills so that you could actually implement what you have done into some program or write a library or find a solution, a numerical solution or an analytical solution to a very narrow problem in some domain. So research can be divided into these types: analytical research, which I just said, which involves calculation and thorough investigation using computational techniques or maybe mathematical methods. Applied research is whatever you study, like in physics, the semiconductor physics and stuff. So we apply that into the fields like nanofabrication of that semiconductors or the plasma fabrication. So these are applied research, like the things which we learned as students, we apply them in laboratories or maybe in numerical investigation to find suitable parameters of experiment and stuff. Fundamental research is like the most basic research, which is done in phenomenology or proposing some hypothesis. Descriptive research is like writing review papers. So I don't know how many of you are aware of review papers, but in every domain, people who are the experts in that field write review papers after some amount of period. Like suppose if I talk about quantum computers, so Richard Feynman coined the term quantum simulations in 1950s or so, 1957 or so, where he said that there is a lot of room, plenty of room at the bottom. So from that time towards at that time transistors were just developing. So from that period to right now, there has been a lot of development in developing a quantum computer. So people who are industry or academia experts in those fields write review papers, which contains basic description of the concepts and what is the progress of the field up to now. And this is a very good point to start with doing research, to read review papers and to see what problems are still open to the field. And similarly about this qualitative and quantitative and empirical research. So I won't be explaining much of these terms because you guys are here for getting to know about Bose.x and not explicitly about research. So, okay, even if you come to Bose.x, how will you do research? There are some definite steps that you have to go through if you want to do successful research or good research actually. So first of all, the very basic thing is to find your interest. You should know what you want to do research on, right? So when I say what you do want to do research, I don't say that you have to like sit and decide, yes, I want to do astrophysics for whole my life and just get started with it. Find the interest which you are ready to give 2 or 3 months or maybe 6 months of your year to that project, devoted to that project. And if you're interested enough, as I said, you can start reviewing literatures. And the first point is to read review papers itself. Read those review papers, read introductory text in that domain to start with the problem. And then start with identifying. Once you have read the review paper, you will have an idea that what open problems can be solvable at my level, at a level which we are working with, right? We are not doing some high-end experiment sitting here. All our work that we are doing is mostly computational and theoretical. So try to develop a sense of problem, like what kind of problem can be formulated, and then try to find what methods can be employed to solve that problem. Like suppose I have an optimization problem. So once I define my optimization parameters, I will start looking for various algorithms or various numerical methods for developing the code for that optimization. And then once you have the data or the results, you should be able to interpret that, right? Even if you produce some plots, you should be able to explain that plot very well, that what characteristics that plot is explaining and what and how it is new. Like it should not be something you have already reproduced from a paper. It should be something new. And then you can, using your documentation skills, you can report that article, or you can frame a small paper and or a poster and present that at international conferences or submit it to journals. And for the sake of information, many of our students in Bose.x have actually published papers and have submitted them in conferences and presented very well. So, what makes good research? Okay. So, purpose should be very well defined for doing whatever you want to do, like the topic which you have at hand. you should know what you actually want to get through it, whether you want to optimize something in that problem, you want to find a new solution to a problem, or you want to improve an existing solution. So that purpose should be clearly defined. And after you have defined your purpose, you should be able to develop a methodology, like how you're going to pursue that problem in the further duration of time, maybe 3 or 4 months. You should have stepwise planning to that problem. And yeah, we have, yeah, in research, you should be very strong with your ethics. You should not copy or something like that, because you cannot actually publish a fake research paper. If you get caught into plagiarism, that is a very bad mark that will have with you for your lifetime. So, and yeah, so the problem which you're dealing with, you have to present a very good analysis of that thing. The project whichever you are doing, it should not look like incomplete or ambiguous. It should be very well defined. Everything should be crystal clear, and the conclusion should be clearly justified, so that anyone who reads it should get a flavor of whatever work has been done there. Yeah, and the final part, how to join us. So if you're interested to join Bosex, we have a website, www.bosex.org. Maybe you can type it and search it in your free time or right now also. So there we have a section, join us. There you will have a Google form link. So you will have to fill that Google form. Once you fill that Google form, we will be notified on mail that some so-and-so candidate has applied, and you will receive a candidate ID for further communication with us. So Bosex backend is almost automated, and this candidate ID will be something that will help us to recognize you and keep in touch with you all the time. And depending upon the your profile and whatever you are interested in, some of the member from our center, or maybe the lead and co-lead of the center, will get in touch with you and discuss the further proceeding of your membership in Bosex. So we usually respond within a week, but yeah, we all are students and we are always busy with some of the other stuff, and there might be some delay, and we expect you to anticipate that delay. Yeah, and the applicant shall be tested on specific skills. Okay, so once you are in Bosex, suppose you don't have the experience and we admit you in the training section. So after you complete your training period, we will test you upon some specific skills that are required for the project. And if you satisfy that requirement already, then you are ready to go with the project in the triad section. Yeah, and I told about leads and co-leads. Okay, so the centers which I described, the X Center for Quantum Research or Astrophysical Research, each section has a person affiliated as a lead of that section, and someone as a co-lead. So there are two or three people who are leading that section and managing all the project updates and stuff of that center. And you can get into contact with them if you want to know anything further about that center. So these are our faculty advisors. They have been constantly supporting us and guiding through the organizational issues and various events, in organizing various events, and also in contributing to research activities. So career, so
Hello, am I audible? Hello? Okay, nice name. So hello guys, my name is Saurabh Sharma, and I'm from Applied Physics Department. Currently I'm in third year. I'm from SVNIT, of course. And I'm working on actually two projects in the under Bosex, and I'm currently the co-lead of the XCAR center of our Bosex. And the one project which I would be explaining to you is related to CMB. So CMB is just cosmic microwave background. So I think most of you know about what cosmic microwave background is, but still I will be explaining in the layman's term. So it's really interesting. So what happens when we know Big Bang happened, then inflation happened, and after the inflation, universe expanded and cooled. So before in early universe, everything was present like a soup and plasma. Electrons and photons are basically coupled together through Thomson scattering and process like this. So when the first time they cool down and the photons get released, photons get decoupled. So the mean free path of photons actually. So let's not get more too much complicated. So the photons get decoupled here from the electrons and the matter. And this was the first time our universe became transparent. Before that, it was opaque and no light was coming to us or coming or emitted from anywhere. Everything was get absorbed into the electrons. As I said, they were coupled together. So when the first photon released in our universe, they were the CMB photons. Now we can detect them in the microwave regions. So we know that it was Penzias and Robert Wilson who detected the CMB photons first. And these photons can give a lot of information about the universe. So this is basically a part of cosmology in astronomy. Cosmology is a subfield, you can say, that cosmology is a subfield in astronomy. There's astrophysics, if you are interested in that, that's a different field. So this CMB lies under the cosmology. So these photons are like a golden mine of cosmological research. They give us a lot of information about cosmological parameters like dark matter density, baryon density, curvature, ionization, and optical depth, scalar perturbation, tensor perturbation, and a much more science we can extract from the CMB photons actually. So what we are working on, we are taking these CMB radiation maps from the satellites. There is a Planck mission which was completed in 2018. We are taking their data and training a machine learning model to detect, to like find out what is the curvature of our universe using the machine learning model and the CMB maps. So this is like basic work of the project in layman's term. So further, there is another field which I'm really interested in, it is 21 centimeter cosmology. So the CMB is like exhaustive field. In a decade or so, it will get exhaust and most of the science will come out of it. And there's nothing left to like, this is actually the guess, but you know, no one can say what can happen in research. So India is also launching a satellite, it's called CMB Bharat. And if you get interested in this topic, it's a really good topic to pursue, but there's a warning, in a decade or so, it will mostly get exhausted. So there's another field like 21 centimeter cosmology, and it's the starting field, just started, very, very young field, and really still also well established if you want to pursue. So I won't be talking about that one as it's not under BOSEX, or if you want to like know about it, you can always ask me. Or if you have any question, you can always ask.
Hello, I'm Janvi from Electrical Engineering Department, second year. I started my research in the very beginning of the second year under a professor of my department. I'm currently working in smart grid and under cybersecurity concerns. Smart grid is all about the future of power systems. You all might be familiar with the power systems, the system which generates and supplies electricity to all our houses. So this is something that keeps me motivated, that future power systems will be consisting of many smart devices and IoT devices. And my research area is not just limited to electrical engineering. It consists of application of various branches like electrical, electronics, and computer as well.
Hello everyone, I'm Abhishek Mondal, second year student at SB19 Department of Chemistry. I'm currently associated with HCRSD, So I like to share my experience about on a project which I recently worked on with Suyash Dipol. So it was about deterministic plasma nanofabrication for production of semiconductors. So it is basically interdisciplinary of plasma chemistry and nanoscience. So it is basically it was a Russian professor K. Ostrikov who started it. So it was basically a production of like it is a deterministic production. So there are many ways of production, like physical methods, chemical methods. So these methods are not so productive of like we are not getting the efficient semiconductors for which we are going to use for the applications, various applications, examples, mobiles or laptops. So this deterministic nanofabrication using plasmas, like we get an efficient, and that amount of input we give, approximately we get exact output. So this was a basic output. So having working for long 9 months, so we were able to get produce some results using computationally, and we were able to present this paper at virtual international conference held at SBNIT February 4th and 5th 2021. So I'm also interested in green chemistry and nanomedicine. If anyone feels working in this field, please feel free to contact me. Thank you.
Hello everyone. I'm Shetang Sekhar. I'm a third year student from physics department of SBNIT. Yeah. Okay, the title of my project is Study of Stellar Evolution Using General Relativity. So you guys must have come across the process of star formation during surfing the YouTube or otherwise. So normally the stellar evolution is explained by the difference in density, and the difference is the density of the stellar mass. So what we are trying to do is that we try to calculate the geometrical general relativistic model for stellar evolution. We use the Thrones 6 partial differential equation in governing the time dependent structure of relativistic star. And that is called by Newton-Raphson technique. So we evaluated the evolution of curvature as the clumps of different masses merge together to form a star, and we try to calculate the curvature.
Yes. Hello everyone, I am Sthai Solanki from IC department, third year. My research work focuses on the relativistic physics like general relativity. I worked on to describe models of compact stars like neutron stars, black holes, white dwarfs, etc. So neutron stars are such a high density stars that are formed of neutrons, and its core density is about 10 to the power 17 kg per meter cube. So that is 10 to the power 14 times more than that of water. So you can imagine how strong the gravity will be. So I worked on to describe such stars and evaluate their properties like mass, density, pressures, and redshifts of it. And now I am currently working to find analytical models that can describe the black holes and its singularity. Like you may have heard that when stars are more than 3 to 4 times that of our solar mass, then it forms black holes, and that compresses and becomes into singularity of very high, like infinitely dense point. So I work on to find the answer of the question that in real world such a singularity can be formed or not by using the quantum matter of description. Yeah, so that's all from my side. Thank you.
Yeah, okay.
Everyone can feel free to speak. We are not judging anybody.
Yeah, you can unmute yourself and just speak. Yeah, you don't need to shy away. So Pranav, you can also speak.
Like if we are doing something, we are carrying research on something like once upon a time, research was carried upon the black body radiations. At that point of time, there was no immediate application of black body radiation, but after some time, applications were developed of black body radiation, for example.
So yes, Harsh, I agree with you. So the same thing happened with the general relativity. When like general relativity was published, there was no concept, there was no application of it, but now we know that every GPS system does run on the basis principle of the general relativity.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes, sure. Hello, everyone. My name is Heer Mehta. I am from Chemical Engineering Department, second year. Actually, my interests are inclined over to quantum mechanics, and just now I am working over quantum spin project. I will explain you what is it. Actually, I am working in the field of quantum computing. Quantum computers are the computers which apply the theories of, we can say, quantum superposition and quantum entanglement. And yes, I am working over it. But the main problem is about decoherence. You can just think about decoherence as a kind of information leak. So yes, we are looking like we are examining the Hamiltonian of the system over the time, its evolution over the time. Yes. We are just examining how can it be reduced.
Yeah, okay. So yeah, the project which Heer is working in, yeah, the same project I'm also working in. The project is basically about controlling decoherence in qubits. Like in classical computers, we have classical bits which are very easy to manipulate using electrical signals, but qubits are somewhat pretty difficult to control over a long period of time, because see, every computation that we do has some amount of computational time required to accomplish that task, right? So we need to have our qubits sustained in superposition till that coherence time, that period of time. So the one of the most promising candidates for qubits is the electron spin qubits, which are basically embedded into quantum dots of silicon or germanium. Whatever I'm telling is, you don't need to get technical details. I'm just trying to just get you a flavor of that. So using semiconductors is an advantage, because all the electronics that we have right now is based on semiconductor technology, and the scalability will be much more higher if we use the quantum computers in this hardware, silicon hardware, or the semiconductor hardware in general. So yeah, so we are trying to develop theoretical and analytical methods to calculate how this electron spin qubits evolve over time, how the entanglement between these qubits can be calculated over time using some exact master equation approach. So people have been trying numerical methods to develop this and trying experimenting this, but here we are trying to develop a theoretical model which would describe the dynamics, and then we are planning to compare that with the actual experimental data that is being done in the laboratories. Yeah. So that is one of our projects in XCQR.
Yeah, just a moment. Just give me a minute. Yeah.
Maybe till then we can take new trivia question or so.
You wanted to ask like why did I switch from mechanical to physics, right? So hello guys, this is Amitesh Singh. I am a BTech final year mechanical student here at SV90, and I'm going to pursue my PhD in physics and astronomy this coming fall semester in the US, as Suyesh and Adi already pointed out. So like I started really believing that research in physics especially can be done after my second year, and how it happened was that obviously I met really good people who motivated me to work. One of the most prominent ones was Mr. Ankul Prajapati, and I'm sure you must have introduced about him, Suyesh, to these guys.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, did you introduce Ankul?
Briefly, I have talked about him, but it would be better if you emphasize
yeah,
more.
Yeah. So he was the one who started this community, and courtesy to him, like, he motivated students like me and others also. So I was a part of technical club of our college, and it was good. I was learning things, but somehow deep inside I knew that I wanted to get into more fundamental stuff. And if you really want to study the physical world around you, I think fundamental sciences are the answer. So what we do as an engineer is applied science, and the science which is already there, we try to improve upon it, or we try to implement this on in real world projects. But I was interested in more of the fundamental stuff, like to answer the fundamental questions. And in 2017, I guess, there was a neutron star, binary neutron star gravitational wave discovery. So in 2015, we got a first signal from the merging black holes. But in 2017, we got the first signal for merging neutron stars. So that interested me quite a bit. But unfortunately, I couldn't start working on them as soon as possible. Because in general, when a undergrad student is starting his work, then he faces many problems. One of them is the lack of motivation and the lack of support from the others. So due to those factors, I was bogged down. But as I pointed out, Ankul and others helped me a lot. And he really inspired me because he was already working from his first year, devoting his time for research, undergrad research. So due to his great influence, I started studying about those gravitational waves, learning just you know, reading some news articles or some really easy stuff to get my hands on with the stuff what is going around in the GW field. So once I was acquainted with the basics of it, I attended a conference, international conference, along with Shashwat and Rajat. And like, it was an international conference held at ICER Mohali, and we presented our work on the data analysis of gravitational wave signals, and classifying them into different kinds of sources based on their GW signatures. So like, there my journey started, and I started believing that I could really transition myself into this. And like, after that time, it was like, things fell into place, and I started working with professors from my own institute, as well as in people from IITs or IISCs. So I started collaborating with a lot of people, and like, naturally, I learned a lot of things. So I kept on attending these webinars or these summer schools, or like, I just loved interacting with people from my field. through conferences or through talks and other things, seminars and all. So like I learned a lot of things there, and then slowly and steadily I could see my way through. Like at the end of the third year, I was convinced that I need to pursue higher research in physics. So I applied to several schools in the US and also in other countries like France and Russia. So fortunately, I got into some of these universities. So after deciding what is best for me, like I really want to get into gravitational wave astronomy, doing data analysis and big data engineering into these fields. Finally, I got what I wanted to pursue. This has been a short summary of like what I have been through. If you have any doubts, you can always email me or you can contact me through the OSEX team page, which Suresh already pointed out, I guess. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, either you can ask or you can also type in the chat box if you are not comfortable asking like this.
So guys, there's no need to like so shy away. We are just students like you. We are not professors and faculties, you know. We are just students like you guys are. So you can always ask freely.
No, there won't be an interview as such, but yeah, some of the co-lead or lead will have a discussion with you to decide if you can start off a project or you'll have to spend time in training section. So for that, you will have to discuss with the lead and co-lead. So once you fill the form, you will receive the email, and through the email, the lead or co-lead will be coordinating with you.
So if there is any like discussion, like Suresh said, it will be to help you guys with the process, and it's not like we are hardcore examining like the well-established institutes just to pick up the top students. It's nothing like that. We are here to train you and help you out with the research. So
yeah,
the
exactly.
Interview won't be a problem. Interview, like, it would be just a discussion to help you out.
So yeah, Divyesh, it is okay if you don't have research experience. We expect that people will not have research experience. So it is for someone like you who does not have research experience, or many of us who are in the meet. So they can join the training section for learning something for a period of time and then starting off a project. So you will need to, as Aditya has told, we can share the information on the Telegram channel about recruitment and all.
So I would like to say, if you are like decided from the start that you want to just hardcore research enthusiast, and you'll end up in a technical institute because of some like here and there issues, so this BOSEX is definitely for you. You should definitely think about joining the BOSEX if you are like very clear about your research purpose, that yes, I do want to do research. If you are not clear, you can take your time to explore, and we are always here. You can come next year also, that's not a problem.
We just want you to know that there is something like BOSOTEX where people are doing something. Whenever you feel a need that you want to explore research, you can get into touch with us. Do you want to take this trivia question, Lars? We shall end this. Yeah, thank you everybody.